Romans 12 gives us two choices. He said, be not conformed to this world.
Be not conformed to this world.
Be not conformed to this world. Because a lot of Christians are.
Because a lot of Christians are. Because a lot of Christians are.
But be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So we all have a choice whether to be a thermostat, 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 or a thermometer. Most people are thermometers. I'm tired, it's cold, this doesn't feel good, but there's thermometers everywhere. If you don't believe it, just walk through the airport. Every voice is complaining about something. They're thermometers. All they can do is tell you how bad it is. But God didn't call you to be a thermometer. He called you to be a thermostat.
Thermostat, 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 thermostat.
He called you to change the atmosphere in the room. And every one of us can say, I can read what temperature it is, and I feel that's this or that, but I want to tell you, I'm not called to be a thermometer. I'm called to be a thermostat. I have the ability, because I'm hooked up to a greater power, to change the temperature in this room, this room, this room, this room, this room, this room, this room.
Okay. I'm out. I'm out. I'm out. What's up? I'm gonna show you the definition of God's favor. Favor is when you go to apply for a job that you're not qualified for, but God opens up that door when everyone else said it was impossible. I'm so blessed and highly favored, walking in the footsteps of my blessed Savior. Blessed and highly favored, walking in the footsteps of my blessed Savior. Yeah, I know favor ain't fair. Yeah, I know favor ain't fair. Yeah, I know favor ain't fair, but I'm blessed and highly favored. Beautiful wife, beautiful kid, beautiful truck, now that's favor. A little nappy head kid growing up, who would've ever thought that I'd be dropping this, bruh? I'm not worthy, but God still blesses. That don't mean that I don't go through tests. You best believe that I still make messes, but God be right there tuning me through all my lessons. I learned that you gotta keep yourself humble. The devil in the squad trying to cause a fumble. You don't wanna wind up in the rumble. Next thing you know, your whole life will just crumble. That's why I try to walk in Jesus' footsteps. Even if I mess around and have to truck it by myself. If he don't do nothing else, man, he done done enough. And yes, he blessed you too, because he woke you up. I'm so blessed and highly favored, walking in the footsteps of my blessed Savior. Blessed and highly favored, walking in the footsteps of my blessed Savior. Yeah, I know favor ain't fair. Yeah, I know favor ain't fair. Yeah, I know favor ain't fair, but I'm blessed and highly favored. I ain't the richest person, but I'm good. Don't have a mansion, but I'm good. I'm walking by faith and not sight. And every time you see me, I be walking in the light. See, I've been doing this rapid thing for a long time. Been putting it down, been on a strong grind. But it's not my will, I'm on Christ's time. The right deal come round, I'm letting Christ sign. Cause he's my agent and my manager. Focus on the king and quit trying to be my challenger. Maybe then you have favor like me, but your heart has to be P-U-R-E. See, Christian rappers ain't my competition, and I ain't trying to flex or start no beefing. I'm just rhyming on this track, what I'm seeing. Cats losing focus, trying to be the best fit in. Lend me your ear, homie, take our time to listen. And I'ma make it real clear, no twisting. We all one, I ain't better than the next man. Start discipling, stop that competing. I'm so blessed and highly favored, walking in the footsteps of my blessed Savior. Blessed and highly favored, walking in the footsteps of my blessed Savior. Yeah, I know favor ain't fair. Yeah, I know favor ain't fair. Yeah, I know favor ain't fair, but I'm blessed and highly favored.
The way I feel about it, real simple. If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, then who can be against you? The way I feel about it, real simple. If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, for you. Since God be for me, I let the haters hate. I may as well, they gon' do it anyway. It be bad. If you got any cake, it be 10 times worse. That's why I do it in their face. Cause if God be for me and the whole world switch out and everybody flip out, I know I ain't finna miss out. If God be for you, he ain't got what you ain't got. You can kill a giant with a rock and a slingshot. The thrill of prayer ain't hot. Somebody gotta straighten me, cause I'ma keep praying, having faith, waiting patiently. Cause if they ain't chipping on my life, summer daycare, cell phone, rent a car, no, to watch your daycare. Cause me, I got the silly faith enough to believe that God can get me high to any state and have my mixtape and every other one.
state,
cause the way I feel about it real simple. If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, then who can be against you? The way I feel about it real simple. If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, for you. If God be for you, hey, be in our vicinity, cause he prepared a table in the presence of your enemies that wanna see you busted and disgusted and defeated. But I don't like the taste of that, so I ain't finna eat it. Cause when God be for you, no matter how you go, they try to pull you down. But the devil is a liar, though the devil is a liar, so the haters can't stop it. And no weapon that they form against you gon' prosper. Good player, top driver out of Duval County. If you ain't by love and getting money, get around me. Adios, arrivederci, sayonara. I gotta get ready for the hate coming tomorrow. Cause the hate coming tomorrow on a whole nother level, a whole nother day, bring a whole nother devil. Stop the music, right? For every hater out there listening, if God be for me, then who can be against me? Against me. The way I feel about it real simple. If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, then who can be against you? The way I feel about it real simple. If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you, then who can be against you? If God be for you.
You know, it's a damper to my spirit sometimes, and I'm not gonna lie, you know, it has been some times where I'm just like, man, the mess that they playing on the radio is just, it's garbage.
We have a problem. We have a problem.
Look, I'm definitely a warrior fighting for the souls and the hearts of people. Again, my passion is for the youth. That's all I'm about, man. It's the youth and the young adults. That's where my heart is for, you know, because a lot of times, even myself, I've experienced death 7 times. And I can count them. And a lot of times, man, the media is so, it's death-driven. It's violent-driven. It's sex-driven. And I see a generation that's trying to, they're basically trying to X our generation out.
The thing is, and it's crazy because there is such a want for Christian rap that you have the fanatical people that do the fanatical things to get Christian rap.
That's when they got the stigma of, oh, rap is bad, and rap is this, and rap is that. It just have a negative influence. Well, these guys, when they were rapping, they were just expressing themselves.
Person respond to what they like. So for people that see Christian rappers and hear music that's good and they like it, they respond to it.
It's about sowing seeds and ministering into lives of this younger generation, you know, so that we can just have new leaders coming up behind us. When we leave and we pass the torch, we want to pass the torch to kids who are excited about what we're doing, excited about the music that we're making.
We have an opportunity now, and this is to embrace the young people and to give them a style of music that's an alternative to come out from what they're listening to. What we got to be careful as a church is when these young people start coming out, that it's not our job to remind them where they came from.
That's what my mission is about, is raising leaders, teaching leaders, showing people their value in life.
You know, when you got people calling you up saying, man, I was about to commit suicide, man, but your CD, I listened to a song on your CD and it saved my life.
Because hip-hop came from, you know, an Afrocentric urban environment, the message was raw, the message was sometimes political, sometimes the message was just street.
I think the first thing people respond to when they hear a song is the beat. like anybody. Like, you don't know the words yet. And most people, the first time you hear a song, you don't know the words. It's a rarity that you see people the first time they go through a song, they know the words.
So, yes, I think people are ready for a cleaner film, cleaner comedy, cleaner music. It's just up to the masses, or not the masses, but it's up to the powers to be to really push cleaner stuff.
I think it's going to blow up. But what's going to happen is, this is my opinion of it, what's going to happen is they're going to blow up without the support of the gospel music industry. And then they're going to see themselves separate as the gospel music industry, because they didn't really support them.
Not only that, I call myself the leader of the youth. He really got a target on my back. He's trying to take this generation out. But with God's help, with my army, with the angels that are around me, there's no weapon formed against me that shall prosper. So the enemy, to you, I say bye-bye and back to hell.
Yeah, 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 it's your man DJ Moore. That's right, y'all. You know what? You can't break us over at Kingdom Affiliates, because we break the hottest urban Christian music first. That's right, y'all. I said first. So right now, if you're a DJ, media rep, check out KingdomAffiliates.com. The DJ's choice for Christian hip-hop and R&B. That's right, y'all. KingdomAffiliates.com. We unbreakable, baby. Ready, ready? Ha-ha!
In life, we all have trials. We all get tested. Without the test, there can be no testimony. So if you're feeling discouraged right now, just wait on the Lord. If you're feeling like you can't make it right now, I'm here to let you know that you can. God can renew your strength. It's always the darkest right before day. Yo, cat, let him know. Show me a sign. I'm praying for your peace. Need some relief from these enemies, but I'm still under siege. Still on my knees, still trying to breathe. The Spirit guided me to Christ of Galilee. He died on the cross, paid all the cost. Straight from that bitter cup, then finished it all off. Blessed be my soul, blessed be my role. King among kings, streets made of gold. Now can I behold the Holy One of old, the only name given that can save my soul. Come on.
Carry me by the power of your breath of life. by his blood till I'm filled with his love. To the fire from above, show the sign of the dove. Till I pass every test, till I feel I'm blessed. Till I end this rest, till I stop this mess. Still fight the good fight, still walk through the night. Trouble with my way, I gotta hold on tight. Cause this trouble can't stay, not in my life. I rebuke the devil, but I'ma no stay flight. Yeah, my light bills due, mortgage too. But I'ma tired that my God's gonna see me through. My bishop telling me just to fast and pray. Life is hard, but this trouble don't last our ways. And when the saints fall down, we get back up. You on your back, it's the perfect time to look back up. It's Christ that brings peace to these raging seas. I'ma trust in your Savior, cause I still believe.
The Lord's divine aside, I'll make it through the night. And it's so hard to see, but God, I still believe. If I just keep the faith, and it's just saving grace. And Lord, I just can't wait, take all my pain away.
The devil's trying to hold me, Holy Ghost come and console me. I'm more than what he told me, I won't let his lies destroy me. I've fought so many battles, now I know he's just my shadow. I gotta stand in my God's might. I gotta fight for my life, so it's on tonight. It's time to stand up, time to fight. Heaven cometh in the morning, but it's hell tonight. God give me some wings, I'll take flight. Carry me by the power of your breath of life. It's time to stand up, time to fight. Heaven cometh in the morning, but it's hell tonight. God give me some wings, I'll take flight. Carry me by the power of your breath of life.
That's not peace, that's
yo, it's the Custo. Keep it locked right here.
Here we go.
You're gonna be okay, kid. You're gonna be okay.
J Menace!
I be on my David flow, speaking spicy goodness. I be on my Asian flow, living for him, not living for sin. It's not an option, optional.
Cause ever since he planted the harvest, the reaping started to grow.
I was in my mess, I was in the rest. I was sinking unlike pants, I needed to be addressed. My life was sinking in my soul, played the Titanic.
Only this time it wasn't the ice, it was the rock who didn't leave me stranded.
I was in that water, thinking I couldn't swim. And Jesus walked up on it and told me, think again. I was drowning in my problem, I was dead in sin, until he revived me, and now I live in him. I live in him. I said I live in him. I live in him. I said I live in him. Dead in sin, but now I live in him. Dead in sin, but now I live in him.
Lending me your ears like Peter, shocking like Franklin, knowing not Aretha. Blessed be the name of Christ as the overseer. Comes running over, blessed by the leader, 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 leader. Get it? Blessed by the leader. Not the liquid, but I really mean the leader. God lifted me up, 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 so I stay driven like I'm running on a meter. Lending me your ears like Peter, shocking like Franklin, knowing not Aretha. Blessed be the name of Christ as the overseer. Comes running over, blessed by the leader. Get it, get it, get it. Blessed by the leader. Not the liquid, but I really mean the leader. God lifted me up, so I stay driven like I'm running on a meter.
I was in the water, I was dead in sin. Jesus walked upon it, told me to think again. I was drowning in my, I was dead in sin. He revived me.
I was in that water, thinking I couldn't swim. And Jesus walked upon it and told me think again. I was drowning in my problem, I was dead in sin, until he revived me, and now I live in him, I live in him, I said I live in him, I live in him, I said I live in him, dead in sin, but now I live in him, dead in sin, but now I live in him.
And when I'm empty, it fills my voice, entering the inner chambers of my being while ministering to that spirit it placed inside of me, forcing joyful sounds from my belly up in praise. My life has been changed from the inside out, and no longer can I just sit and look, but I have to stand and shout, because this thing is taking over my mind, my body, my soul. Jehovah is what I know him to be. That's who he is to me. Shalom, quiet in my storms, surrounded me with peace. Jehovah Nisi, he who erases my fear in the face of my enemies, fighting all my battles with victory. I'm blessed to say that I know him. Live, eat, breathe, and grow in him. The lover of my soul, the keeper of my destiny, and greater is he that is in me than he that's in this world. And he spoils me with his mercy, making me more and more thirsty for his word, standing on his promises, daily dying to myself within. I'm not missing out on what this world is offering. Heartache, headache, pain disguised as fun. In me is the one who formed the universe, able to erase the curse of sin that plagues so many men, who's caught up in themselves. If only they'll let the spirit endow them and stop denying him as Jehovah Jireh. He that sets the very sunrise on the horizon, the creator of life. See, many come in his name, but don't know him. Claim to be washed in his blood, but have nothing to show of him. Never bleeding one scripture off their tongue to cleanse a bum or tell the beaten woman of the one who can save her life. Never stopping to speak peace to reject a teenager who's contemplating suicide and who's too scared to say a prayer to the drunk or prostitute on the street. But see, Jesus came in the flesh for a reason, was crucified, died, buried, then rose, not for our amusement, but that we may receive him eternally, undoubtedly, govern our temple, leaving no room for simple idiocies of this flesh, bringing all forms of ungodliness under subjection to the truth, putting the ball in our court to choose, self or Jesus, nonsense or reason. In me, Jehovah is who I know him to be. Elohim, reigning in all greatness and glory. The one to whom I would always stay true. So now it is your turn to decide what's inside of you.
Nobody knows what's going on. I'm gonna tell you different.
Nobody knows.
nobody knows.
Does anybody care?
Does anybody care?
I feel alone. I'm
feeling alone.
Is there anybody there?
Is anybody there?
My heart beats. I've cried many tears.
Too many tears, y'all.
I need to know.
I get lonely too, I am human, I'm flawed to the core, apple seeds, I want my wants, but my needs are a necessity, my lady's kinda sick of me, friends are the new enemies, apparently, relation with family's at a standstill, my phone was cut off, I couldn't pay the bill, yeah, I socialize over the networks, no one wants to see my face even on Facebook, so to my space, no invitations. Hard to get a friend request as a Christian musician. I don't bite the bullet, man, I chew on it. Even sneezing for a blessing, I can't find it. I never mind it, close my eyes to it. Hopefully I wake up to a life not ruined.
Nobody knows.
Nobody knows.
Does anybody care?
Does anybody care?
I feel alone.
Feeling alone.
Is there anybody there?
Is anybody there?
My heart beats.
Y'all.
I need to know, is there anybody there?
Yeah, life is a gift, don't you agree? What's the point in loving only those close to me? Life without pain, a tragedy. We'd all be the same height, no growth mentally. Yeah, so I thank all of my frenemies. Without you, I would not have made it possibly. But I guess I proved you all wrong. I can live with myself even if I walk alone. You know why? Why? Cause God is on my side. I love myself too much to allow my dreams to die.
Robin Lynn presents
me, it made me stronger. Without you, I say hold on a little longer. Every friend I lose get clean shots like a sniper. Aim for success, attack my dream just like a viper. And once I strike, there's nothing that can stop it. It's lonely at the top, at least I made progress. Yeah, yeah, yeah. At least I made progress. You know, one thing I realized is that sometimes we go through life and go through different situations, and we feel like really nobody knows what we're going through. But I'm here to tell you that there's always one person that does know, and that's God.
Nobody knows.
Nobody knows.
Does anybody care?
Does anybody care?
I feel alone.
Alone.
Is there anybody there?
Is anybody there?
My heart beats. I've cried many tears.
Too many tears, y'all.
I need to know. Is there anybody there?
You know, one thing I realize is that sometimes we go through life and go through different situations, and we feel like really nobody knows what we're going through. But I'm here to tell you.
Still hanging with your brother in Christ, DJ Brother Trey. This next artist is coming up, has been a part of some legendary hip-hop groups. You heard of them, 95 South, 69 Boys, Quad City DJs. They're responsible for some major hits like Tootsie Roll, Whoop, There It Is. And look at those girls with them Daisy Dukes on. And the rodeo. I'm gonna bring to you the artist named Thrill the Player. And he's got a wonderful testimony that I want everybody to check out. So remember to keep it locked right here.
Then of course I want to thank God, man, for freeing me and allowing me to be able to share my testimony, my story with y'all. And even though it's got its ups and downs, is a story of hope. And I tell this story because, you know, even when I go to church sometimes, I be sitting there like, man, I wonder what that preacher went through to get to where he at. And, you know, sometimes we hear stories, they give good sermons, but if you knew the story behind the person, man, I watch ETV, Biography Channel, all that, I be trying to learn, because it be inspiring. So, I guess I'll start, Duval County, everybody know, Thrill the Player, for those of you who don't know me, of course, from 69 Boys, but I started in Duval County, Jacksonville, Florida. I got the name Thrill, because I played football at Fletcher High School, what up to all the cynicals out there. And everybody would call me the Christian rapper even back then, you know, because I was a virgin, captain of the football team, all this. But on the football field, oh, he would thrill the crowd with such amazing moves. So everybody just called me Thrill Hill. But I had this amazing attitude, too. I just knew I was the world, so I messed up my college scholarship. I opted to go to the Army because I figured if, you know, I go, my skills ain't going to diminish. I go get the GI Bill, come back. And, you know, parlay that into scholarship money and GI money. So, you know, still hustling in my mind, just being a hustler from Duval County. But went away to the military, came back, you know, came back, worked at my goddad's record shop. Shots out the Big Alley. Everybody in Jacksonville know me from the record shop. And, you know, I had a ton of cars. And I say that not bragging, because I tell all these jits out here in the streets today, man, these streets today ain't like they used to be, man. You could really make real money in them streets, and that's not nothing I condone, man, but it's something that when you're out there and you're doing it, you're doing what you do, it is what it is. Not nothing I choose to brag about, but I say I had all these different cars I was driving up to the record shop every day. The police finally raided the record shop. Around this time, me and AB and Carlos from 95 South, we had a group called Major League. But we was more so hip-hop, because Naughty by Nature was out. We was like, okay, we're going to be, you know, the Florida version of that. You know, cats from Florida, that be our problem too, man. We don't know how to be proud of our own sound. We got our own sound from back with Luke and everything, to where people that wanted that sound have to come to us, but we'd rather be something else. So that was my problem in the beginning. But I'm going to let that be a testimony and show you how you can miss out on something. So we went to the studio. Well, AB and Carlos went, because Jay Ski, AB older brother, was like, man, I got something I want to try, this new sound. And it was more so the Florida sound. But I was like, nah, man, we don't put this money into this major league, I ain't going. So that night they recorded the first version of Whoop, There It Is. And that's when I learned that you don't know everything, because then I was like, okay, I want to be in it now, because it was jamming. But they were like, nope, too late. So I had to sit back, fall back, but I was still at the record shop. I used to go on the road with 95 South, balled out with them, again, being in these streets, just young, wide open, 5 cars before Tootsie Roll ever even came out. You can go to Duval. Matter of fact, let me say this, because I got to represent for the North Side. The first drop top Lexus, that was back in 91. In Jacksonville, belong to moi. Cut the fronts and backs off the turf cell, drop top style, doing my thing. Anyway, back to the story. Had to do that for the haters. Back to the story. The music thing blew up, 95 South took off. I was able to get some writers on that album, because I came in, was able to write some remixes, the remix to Whoop, There It Is, and moved to Orlando. Around that time, everybody at the crib, you know, because they knew me from the streets, they'll be like, man, Buddy be on Pearl, Buddy be on this, Buddy be on that. People knew me from the beach. Shouts out to everybody out there on the beach. A real street dude, but just chasing my dreams in this music, man. It was no music industry in Jacksonville. Everybody like, why they love the crib? Why they love Duval? Because, man, when you got to follow your dreams, you got to go where it's at. If you want to be a longshoreman, Jacksonville is the place to be. That's what you go. That's where you go. That's what you do. So, anyway, we moved down to Orlando. I followed my dream. At the time, I think, yeah, I still had 3 cars left. You know, but I still had the crib in Jacksonville that I'm paying for with no job. That's why I don't even tell my kids, you need to get a job, because you don't know how the Lord be speaking to somebody. I tell them, you need to keep an income. You know, and if that means getting a job, because the Lord will make a way for you, because when you have to, when you want to dedicate yourself to a dream, you have to go full time. And the Lord may say, okay, I need you to go get a job, to do this, that, and the third. But at the same time, God created a way for me to write music behind the scenes where I wasn't physically working, but I would still have women tell me, you need to get a job. My mom and them be like, oh, you need to get a job. But at the same time, God was building a dream. So I have my 3 cars in storage. We down here in Orlando. Shots out to Pine Hill. Everybody in Orlando knew, you know, 95 South, 69 Boys, Quad City DJ, CC Lemonhead, this and that, all of us stayed in the same house. It was like 15, 16, well, actually 18 of us in a three-bedroom house in Pine Hills. You had CC, his wife and baby had one of the bedrooms, this and that. Since they were females, they had the other bedroom. The studio was in the other bedroom, two bathrooms. So that means it was 14 of us sleeping between the living room and the den. And it was like that for like 2 years. Well, 95 South had started making money, so they moved out. Me, I was selling cars. Like, I had 3 cars, so when money got low, I couldn't afford to get no job, because I'm noticing every time they need a big song wrote, I'm the only one at the studio. So, by default, I'm getting to write all the hits, thanks to the grace of God. But I'm selling cars just to keep money in my pocket. My album was supposed to come out, it didn't, this and that album came out. So anyway, fast forward, 69 Boys album came out. Shouts out to Rippy Ruffin, shouts out to Jay Ski, CC Lemonhead, everybody that was a part of my career initially. You know, I will say, for everybody who wonder why that whole Quad City clique split up, I would just say, from my standpoint, it's all about a work ethic, man. We just, if you can stay grinding when it's hot, man, it's always gonna last. Loyalty, no matter who you is in this business, you find out some things is this, some things ain't that. But my thing is, you never disrespect the people that bought you in the game, man. You just count it all a lesson, learn, and let that be a blessing to you. So, all that stuff fell out. Tootsie Roll blew up. We stayed independent now during this. It ain't like we ran to no label like, oh yeah, give us some bread, da da da. Cause we seeing how we making independent money. We going around the world, you know. But I'm young, I ain't got no guidance, you know. This car, that car, that car, this car. One day I had ran into a police up there on Silver Star and Powers. And he was like, yeah, man, I just want to apologize to you. We've been investigating you for like the past 8 months, man. We see your house over there on Clark Corner Court, man. We, you know, so many cars. You know, I just had to apologize to you. He was with his little son. I want to introduce my son to you. I'm Sergeant such and such, but we had your phones tapped. We was just in, but we come to find out that you trying to do something positive with your life, with this music. Your music ain't got all this cussing in it, this, that, and the third. That was another lesson taught to me. You be around here, just wilding like you know something. Many people be having you under surveillance, and you could be totally innocent. But anyway, all right, so we traveling all around the world, blowing up, doing this, that, and the third. I'm out here sleeping with all kind of women, raw dog, every night, just wild, and just don't even like condoms. Just look, man, she look clean. She, it wasn't, okay, I'm gonna tell you, let that be a lesson too. Grace of God, I stand here today, disease free. But I ain't gonna never say I ain't got nothing. You know what I'm saying? Chlamydia, all that, yeah, that be real. So, you know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm just saying, let that be a testimony for whatever. I'm just trying to be transparent. Anyway, fast forward, Tootsie Roll blows up. Around this time, the royalty stuff get funny, so we take some break off. Everybody like, where's 69 Boys? But 95 South had dropped. You know, we doing a lot of soundtracks. Dr. Doolittle, Space Jam, Nothing to Lose. Blue Street. Sunset Park. Just so many to be, and a lot more. But I said all that to say this, because that's what kept me alive. To all you writers out there, when you write your music, man, I have sold over 35 million units, and I have never got a royalty check from none of them units. I'm talking about soundtracks and all. Never have, because my publisher has been so blessed, man. I haven't had to. Well, let me get off track. Let me say this. Okay, so Tootsie Roll blow up. Then, as stuff start to slow up because we not recording, Atlantic steps in. They say, okay, look, we want you over here with us. We'll pay off all your old royalties with your old label. We'll pay your lawyer fees. We'll get you out your contract. And I was so ready to get out. I'm like, okay, let's do that. Plus, we'll get them some points on the new album. We're just going to keep it moving. I just want to be out of this. I want to get my expression out. By this time, we had the album, The Wait Is Over. We had been recording it for the whole 2 years. So by that time, No Limit had came out. They was on the buzz. They was coming up. But we got the singer, Dr. Doolittle, but the sound was changing. DJs wasn't quite playing the bass music no more. They was more so into the dance sound. I mean, the crunk club sound of No Limit. Cash Money hadn't yet came along, but they was on the verge. Lil Jon them and So Duff, they was doing their thing in Atlanta. So the sound was changing. Shows wasn't as plentiful. And anybody that know me knew, like, I don't wait for nobody to cut no check for me, bro. I believe in me. People, a lot of people say, well, you want to invest in yourself, spend somebody else's money. No, I believe you and believe in yourself. And God bless you with something, you spend your own money. So by this time, record slowing down. IRS done called me. Oh, look, we need to holler at you, buddy. You owe us X amount, this, that, and the third. And I can't blame none of that on management. Because I'm telling you, I'm talking about, it was weekends where I was like, I got a Hummer. But they'll be like, oh, Gainesville this week, it's the step show at FUF. Oh, for real? I just go to the Lexus dealership, be like, hey, look, man, I want this car. I ain't got time to fill out the paperwork. Just let me get this here. Here go 10 grand. I'll be back Monday. They'll tell me come back 2 weeks, whenever. Lucky, they don't even call. They just be like, okay, we know you're going to come back. You don't bought 5 cars. Just take it. Just take the keys. Go and do whatever. I'm just buying cars just for an event. Like, I'm changing. Oh, for real? Okay. All right. So, anyway, the IRS calls. Hey, we need to holler at you, buddy. Boom, 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 boom. Hold on. I got to get something to drink, y'all. Okay. Anyway, I asked Atlantic for my release. So we can take whatever steam we had left from our career and just try to flip it for this independent thing. And Craig Calman, you know, I was very instrumental on helping Slip and Slide and Atlantic come together. I pulled Ted Lucas and Craig Calman together. I was able to pull that deal together tonight. In it. I mean, I'm saying that because I want you to say, even behind the scenes, you can make moves. And this is how God has blessed my life, even behind the scenes, to allow me to be relevant. So as this story keep going, y'all understand how it all ties together. So, with that being said, they gave me a release, and by this time I'm saying, okay, I got X amount left, I know what it's going to take, if I could just find a company to distribute my music and match my marketing and promotions budget, because I had just watched what Slip and Slide did with Warlock, you know, on that, on Now, when they dropped Now, they ain't like they had no major, the majors came coming, you know, so, I went with Doc Hollywood Interscope. Yeah, Doc Hollywood Interscope / Universal with an album called 2069. Now this was the real lesson, y'all, because anybody that know me know during the time when I had the ball, oh, I balls with everybody. But I went to a lot of people that I knew at the time and asked them for their help, and they could not help me. And that taught me a lot then. Like, you know, everybody that be ready to ride on the tour bus when it's time to go, they not finna be like, Oh, I'll ride or die. As soon as the shot go out, they the first one to dip. And even some of the last ones to dip, man. If you're going to stand by something, stand by it. Believe in it. But what I will say is that taught me the meaning of true friendship. So at the time, when even my friends wasn't there for me, I feel, you know, I took it back to what I knew, which was the streets. I went to Cats and I was like, look, bro, this is what I'm trying to do. This is my plan. And to my surprise, man, people like, even like Dice Ruckers, for that whole 2069 album, I didn't have no budget, because I was trying to match Doc Hollywood. I told them if they matched the 50 grand I had with 50 grand for marketing and promotion, I knew I could at least probably buy a couple of BET shows, or buy my way up to get some exposure, to get on a couple of BET shows, so on and so forth. So, Cass was like, oh man, you don't need to mess with Dice now, man, da 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 da. Them the only people gave me studio time. Man, them boys gave me, it probably invoiced out close to $100,000 at studio time. And people I knew who I had done spent that kind of money with wouldn't even let me come in their studio. And that hurt me, but it taught me. And to this day, I ain't even paid them boys all that bread back, but they don't even sweat it. And that's love. So I want to say that. People like them, people like Kurt Josephs, people like Adam Gutman, people that's just been down with me through the struggle. In fact, people like Nino, cats like Nino. I don't know if a lot of cats in Orlando know Nino. He used to own the Palladium. He had a club down in Melbourne. Nino saw what I was going through. Mr. Dickey, he came to me and bought 4 shows for the Palladium and for Mount Dora area down there. And then the feds picked them up right after that. We didn't even never get a chance to do the shows, but he saw what I was trying to do. But they was there for me, even when people was like, oh, you don't need to do this. Now these people that stuff stayed with me, probably 5, 6, 7 years, rent free, balling on. Anyway, we ain't even gonna get into that. That's in the movie and the book, because you know I still gotta get paid off that before I tell that story. But anyway, so we released the 2069, a single on there, How We Roll. It blows up. So in my heart, I'm knowing that, you know, a dream is coming true. Like, because independently, it was nobody that believed that we could leave the situation we was under and still stand up in the paint. But a lot of people got behind that project. Shouts out to Merv, shouts out to Dog Man, Julia Beverly, everybody that believed in that project from the beginning. A lot of people was in Orlando, a lot of people in Tallahassee, a lot of people in Jacksonville. But anyway, the 2069, I actually ended up sound scanning close to 80,000 units. And back then, independent record stores, mom and pops, was real big. So we was selling more units to the mom and pops than we was just on the sound scan. So we moved enough units to where we made close to like 1.2 million on the deal. In the middle of all that, my biggest lesson probably ever, because this is how you really find out who your friends is, because the company we was with filed for bankruptcy with the money. So you waiting in between there, you don't invest at all, because that was what I had. I put myself believing in me out there, or what I thought was, but all through this, I'm looking at it as a bad situation, because now I owe people, and that's actually how I created such a huge debt with it. When I look at it as the music industry, sort of like Sony or Atlantic or anybody would create this debt building their company, any Fortune 5 company, I created all this debt to build a company. But it made me feel good because we knew it could work. And that's how we found out who everybody was and how everybody was and who was in it for the business and who was in it about the business. Because it was sometimes I go to sleep and God brought me through that situation. Because there were times where I was sleeping, like with my AK, my grenade launcher up under the bed. I'm just like waking up, like I'm thinking I'm hearing stuff all times of night, man. It's been times when folk done call my house, look here, bro, it's gonna be this by this time or this or this time. And I would prepare for whatever at whatever time. Not to say that, oh, I was prepared to take on any army, but I'm saying, like, when you don't feel death no more, you just, when you know that only thing you can do is meet God, you don't feel death. Like, what? How bad can meeting God be? You feel me? But at the same time, I always felt I'm gonna take one or two with me. That was just always my attitude. God, forgive me. That was my attitude then. My attitude now. Well, anyway, let's get back to the story. So, with that being said, man, God brought me through all of that. I'm one of the only cats you know. I ain't gonna say one of the only cats you know, but I know. When I went to the streets for damn near $1 million, and in less than 10 years, I stand here today, almost unpaid, every penny back to the streets. That's a true story. Not nothing to brag over, because I ain't sold one narcotic to do it. I wrote Tootsie Roll Space Jam. I'm talking about the IRS came and got over 100,000 in back royalties. So I ain't never got to work. I wrote them songs, some of the biggest songs you ever heard. But we still got royalties out there. We gonna go get them. God just showed me, because it was a time during all that time where I got mixed up in ecstasy, prescription drugs, where he showed me, had he released all that to me, that I'd have blew it, I'd have been gone, it'd have took me out. But it was something bigger for me to do. So that's why when you hear this music, that's why when people be like, Thrill, why you won't go back to making the kind of music like Tootsie Roll? Because my life bigger than that now. Like, I got a story that has to be told to help somebody else's life. People have to know that you could be a stand-up person in the paint. Because I can promise y'all that ain't nobody stood up in the paint for me the way God has when I went through what I went through. And you can take that for good or for bad. And everything ain't right in my life now. But you can still keep pressing forward. You can pay the IRS off, like God blessed me to do. You can pay your debt back to the street, like God allowed me to do. And still to this day, when you see me, you see what's real. And it's so much more freer than me having to have 20 cars. You know, I can ball in what's comfortable and wake up every day and do what God called me to do. So if God give you a dream, pursue your dream. Don't never let nobody else tell your story. This is a story. A lot of people got a story. 50 Cent's story is he got shot a bunch of times and he was able to overcome that. Some cat's story might be, you know, I came from the struggle and overcame this, that, and the third. My story is, thanks to the grace of God, that I always wanted to be one of hope. When we came out with Tootsie Roll in that first album, it wasn't no cussing on that album, because I stood up and said, look, I don't want to cuss on that album. And just let this be a business lesson to all of y'all. It was one, not cuss word, but the N word that my dog Rottweiler used. And we approved it on Survival of the Fittest, but that got that one N word got our record in the height of our record pulled out of every Walmart store because a little 8-year-old had bought our album. His mama heard him listen to the album, heard the N-word, took it back to Walmart. They called us and said, look, we putting your record off all the shelves because we are a Christian company. We don't believe in selling music with profane language in it in our stores. You know what I'm saying? That taught me, you got to go through it with a fine tooth comb. And even through my struggles, it was times where frustration might have came out of my music. I want to repent to my fans for that. But as an artist, I don't repent because it had to come out. It's been times along the way when I've been blessed with a hit like the Grey Goose and Yin Yang Twins. Man, I could tell y'all this story for 20 more minutes. But the hit with Grey Goose, we could have pursued that record and blew it up and all this and all that. But when I'm going to the shows in the early stages of the record and we looking at 8-year-olds throw their middle finger up, and you know, Kool-Aid in their cup. I'm like, an 8-year-old throwing their middle finger up? They don't even know what we talking about, but this is the power of music. God showed me I could either pursue that like I pursued what I thought I was pursuing before, or I could take my time, follow his guidelines, do what I have to do on my way back to the top, as he blessed me with his solo career. And I just ask y'all to ride with us all the way on through. You feel me? User Friendly is the album. Thrill the Player is the name. God bless y'all. We out. Hey, Mr. Bright, I got a shout out to Mr. Bright. Thank you, man, for the new age studio time you blessed me with, man. Most definitely shouts out to Keenan McCardell. That's one of my people, man. Y'all might not remember Keenan played for the Jacksonville Jaguars, San Diego Chargers. Edgar Bennett from the Green Bay Packers. I shout out to Dice, i.e. Shredder. Shouts out to Nino. Shouts out to everybody that's been at my family. My family. My family. My family. My first wife. My ex-wife. She could have been a lot more nastier in the divorce, but she wasn't. She allowed me to live. She could have been trying to get half of the back royalties. It just could have been real nasty. Thank you. Thanks to my kids for your patience. Thanks to my fans. Thanks to Stevie the Man for giving me my first chance in radio. Because y'all might not know, Ghetto Fabulous Live syndicated radio, successful radio show that we have that I've been blessed with. And I got to shout out like two of my artistical inspirations. 112 Pac, one of the realest people I ever met. Like, no matter where you saw Pac get, like, he act like he knew you and showed you love like a real, like y'all really knew each other. Like, y'all just carried on conversation. It was just that. It didn't matter who he was with. And a lot of people ain't like that in this industry. And also, shouts out to JT Money, because that's one person that, like, when he heard the buzz of how we was going through industry woes and everything, he didn't wait. He reached out. He had a song, I, who that, who that, who that. In the height of his deal with Priority, he reached out to me like, hey, baby, what's going on? Heard some things, you know what I'm saying? Get at your boy if you need anything. And I was able to call JT up, man. It's just so much stories I could tell y'all. Y'all just keep a lookout in the future for the books and the movies that's going to tell the whole unadulterated truths. The testimonies, man. Let it help somebody life. Anybody that ever been there for me, I ain't forgot you. When it blow, we gon' ball, baby, ball, baby. Hey! Peace. And to my wife, I know you thought I forgot about you, boo. I ain't forget about you, baby. I ain't sleeping on the sofa tonight.
Thanks, listening friends. And remember to check out Divine Experience Radio and Urban Experience Radio. We're online 24/7. Be blessed.
Sings in our recent picture that we performed in together, the St. Louis Blues.
You know, Nat, I've never been in the movies and never been in Hollywood.
Mm.
And when they asked me to be in this picture with you, I was so scared coming to Hollywood, I didn't know what to do.
Well.
But when I saw you, I knew everything was going to be all right.
Well, with you around, hey, everything's got to be all right. I hope so. Right now, with the help of the cheerleaders and Nelson Riddle and the orchestra, we'd like to show our audience what songs are really made of. You know, how we get together. Would you like to join us?
I'd love to.
All right, stand by.
Thank you.
I've got a new song for all of the praisers. Are you ready? People of every nation, every color and creed, from ocean to ocean, let's join together as one great church with one great praise.
Power,
greater than ours.
Hello? Hey, why you hang up on me? Hello? Why you no hang up on me? I'm trying to talk to you. Probably because the internet is not strong enough to push that band. I don't want to call on Facebook. Where are you at? Oh, I don't want him there. I want you on the... Where's the recent app? Aristotle New. That's what I need. Where is Aristotle? I'm going crazy. There we go. I don't want your Facebook. Alright, this is crazy. Aristotle. Where's the new one? There it is. You gotta come online. Alright, where's my Facebook now? You guys are too funny. Yeah, he talking about, hold on a minute. He's on the phone. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I got a short in my thing, and I was working on something. Where did I... How do I change this camera? Why is that not showing up? Sources. Yeah, you're funny. Why is that not showing up? I'm sending you an agreement. Okay. I'm like really confused with my camera.
There's a lot going on over there.
Oh, I was working on DJ Momo. He got a show on my Spreaker network, and so he wanted me to put the vibes live and some text on there and make them a thingy, and then I did whatever I did, and now I can't get my camera back to myself over here. I got so much stuff going on. I am wired for sound and everything. It's just ridiculous. And so I put stuff somewhere, and then I don't know what I did, and it's crazy. Now go back here. Why isn't any of this giving me... I want... Okay, I see what I have to do. Take it to that. I don't think I can do that. Anyway, I'm just waiting for him to get off the phone. What are you snacking on?
Salmon.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Salmon and rice.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How's it going in the studio?
Phenomenal. The music that I'm making is so crazy right now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm actually making the kind of music that, in retrospect, I really think that 50, 60 years from now is going to be around.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and to me, that's one of the most important things.
Mm-hmm.
I want to live forever through my music.
Mm-hmm.
But got to get a couple of things together with this ad campaign company.
Uh-huh.
So now I can't even do a mixtape record anymore.
Yeah, you was telling me. Yeah.
Everything has to be off the margin. They're like, look, no mixtapes, no mixtape type records, none mm-hmm. of that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and see, this whole time I've been telling everyone that I thought going that mixtape route inevitably was wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So now we coming to see in fruition that, you know what, I was right.
Yeah, see, well, it's just because it's a bunch of mumbo jumbo, it's a bunch of hooey, it's a bunch of fluff, it's not sustenance. And then it's what I have been realizing is that we have sounds and noises being accepted as music. And that's what these mixtapes are comprised of, and so it kind of dilutes it. It's not really an art, it's a art form, and unfortunately it is going to kind of stick because of but it's absurd. But yeah, you got this crazy music, and then it ends up in the mixtape. What's a mixtape? It's a compilation of a bunch of stuff, a bunch of bits and snippets and parts and samples that people don't put together because they're not musicians, and they don't have the access to learn how to do music, but they still have the music in them. So they go get these square little boxes and put sliders on them, and they engineer noise and put it together on these mixtapes. And so they say, they tell you, nah, man, nah, this is of a different caliber. That stuff, I don't know what that stuff is, but whatever it is, don't you dare show your face over there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, this is basically where I'm at with it. Like,
yeah.
I don't understand a lot of the music that's out, and I don't relate to it. You know what I mean? Like, because that's not the era of music that I come from, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm still young, and but, you know, I listen to the, you know, the OJs and the Shy Lights, the Temptations.
Yeah, see.
And one of the things that is universal about their music, wait, hold on one second, Rob.
All right. Aristotle need to turn. Oh, I think he's got a Skype on, or maybe that's his Facebook. And this needs to come on. What is wrong with my stuff? It's like my camera's not working. And now let's go back here. Go to, what's that? Oh, that's you. It's like, what is that? Options. I don't even want to play no more. This camera's driving me crazy. Why won't it pick up my camera? I plugged it in. Maybe because I need to try another port. How about that? Since you want to be like that. Let me show you how it's done, son. I bet you I don't, though. That should be plugging in. It should be registering when I plug it in. So, why isn't it? Oh, well.
Alright, right. You figured that out, Rob?
I keep plugging my camera in, and it's not recognizing it. Maybe because I've got something in use. Oh, well. It's no biggie.
Did you open it? Use another thing to open it?
The camera was actually unplugged. Sang it. Stop. That's what my daughter be doing to me. She's like, Ma, Ma, yep. And I just sang anyway. I don't care. And then she'd be like, Mom, do you be singing loud like that all on the air? And I go, yeah. She goes, really? I go, uh-huh. I do what I do. I don't care. Shoot, it's my radio station. What? Yeah. If I'm singing in my house, I'm going to sing. Yeah. But she goes, Mom, you can't sing. Well, obviously I can sing because I be singing. She goes, that's not what I'm saying. I don't care what you're saying. Okay. Now, where is he? Let me move your little pictures. This guy. I told him that. He said he was on the phone. He said, hold on, he's on the phone. I told him, no, hang up. Hang up in their face. It's okay.
Man, it's crazy.
You broke up a little bit. What happened?
I said, now it's raining ice out here.
Oh, yeah, it's that weather's getting ready to be really crazy around everywhere. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I can.
Okay. Kind of wish, we here waiting for you. Just log on to Skype and give a call. When you're ready. Yeah, tell him, look, I got you up. Now I finally got Coach up. Get up. Come on. You guys play too much. I went to sleep after the both of you did. And I got up before you both did.
Go to sleep after I did.
Yes, I did.
What time did you go to sleep?
I went to sleep after you did.
Exactly. You go to sleep after I did. I know you didn't.
No, I didn't. You actually had gotten up. You had actually gone to bed when I had gotten up again. So I got up about 4 this morning, and so that's 7 my time, and you were still up working then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't go to sleep until 9:15 this morning.
That's right, but I think when I started calling you, too, I was like, because I had been willing and deal. Lynn, Dejami done sent me over the terminology for the thing, okay. for the contract for Eddie Stoked, Black Furious NG. I'd already had a conversation with NG before I went to bed last night. I sent NG a message and I said, listen, and Vibes Live would be honored to, here he comes too, would be honored to be to provide your promotional management services, you know. And so and so you'll need to talk to you'll need, so he was like, oh yeah, I bet. And so he was like, and I go, no, you need to talk to our the Vibes Live A&R department, which you've already talked to. That's Coach Real, so you have to talk to him. And he's like, oh, okay. And so I says, well, I'll set up a conference call. And so when I got up this morning, I was like, I was up, and I was like, yeah, well, I'm ready to handle this because I got stuff I got to do, sitting around worrying about all these details. Okay, there we go. All right, what is really going on here?
Hello.
Hello, we're all here. Coach, you. Coach, you. Okay. We're all here now. We've got the Vibes Live A&R department online with Furious NG.
Yeah, I'm here, man. What's up, Coach?
What's going on, boss? How you feeling?
I'm doing good, man. What's up? What time is it over there?
Over on my side, I'm on the East Coast. It's 1 o'clock in the afternoon.
Oh, I got you. Over Paris, it's 9 o'clock, you know, afternoon.
And I'm in Seattle. It's 10 on the West Coast. It's 10 a.m.
Yeah, 3 different time zones.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So what's shaking with your? What are you doing out there in Paris exactly?
I'm artist, you know. I'm free. I'm a senior artist. I don't have no library or something like that. I do it myself thing, you know. When I get money, I go to the studio, record it, I release my music on the nerds, you know. So right now, I start to have a lot of people around the world who support my music. That's why I talk to Robin, if he can manage my music or something like that, and help me to sell from iTunes or something like that, you know. I'm free.
Okay. So where do you be posting your music at? Or do you put it online?
I just put on YouTube, something like that, Rebel V Nation. I don't stop to make myself promo on Facebook or something like that, you know. Just that, just what I
do. Do you have a Rebel page?
I don't think. A Rebel page? Well, what you mean by Rebel page?
Reverb Nation.
What?
Reverb Nation.
I got it.
Yes, yes, he does.
If you search NG Space Black, you can see my river said. I'm ranked number one. I was number one. Now I'm number two in Paris.
Okay.
Yes, good thing. That's what I wanted to see. All right, look. This is what we're gonna do. We're gonna give you a promo management contract, and what that's gonna cover is we're gonna promote you. We're gonna feature you. On the radio station, set your iTunes, your Amazon, and we'll fully promote you and build whatever other ranking that you don't have, like SoundCloud.
Mm-hmm.
We'll get you SoundCloud together and keep that up, and then we'll keep your stats going up back to where they're supposed to be on Reverb, so that you stay at number one.
I got you, Coach. Got yeah. PlayStation. I got SoundCloud too. I got it.
Yeah.
So you gonna like to promote me, man. You know, I got people. I told you, I got people.
Yes.
I got people in Swarovski. You know, I got people. I got a lot of people. You ready? I come here to tell them about each and a trick. They wait for to buy it. I know everyone who showing Black Love, he got to buy this shirt from H&S, you know. So
okay.
You and Robbie Lane to see what you can do for me, man. I don't know how much I can say thanks, you know.
Yeah.
I work together. I work with my homie from California, Omar, who rap like Eminem. I don't know if you listen to the track Last Generation.
Last Generation. Coach Real, he's been like in the studio and stuff like that, and so I don't think I've exposed him to a lot of your music, but I'll get it over to him.
To me, he needs to listen what I do.
Yes.
Right, you know?
Yeah.
Something like that. You know?
Well,
before.
Yeah. He is aware because I've been telling him and I've been talking to him and stuff like that. But I don't think he's heard Lost Generation because he's been busy on the grind and in the studio, his own self too. And so I haven't had a chance to
Prize him with some stuff. Wait, record did you play yesterday?
Yes, I played that yesterday. It's the song that we played six times yesterday.
Alright.
Yeah. Okay. He heard it. He did hear it. And then
it's Underground King, Underground Legend, the project like Underground Legend. I got project what I call Underground Legend. I got artists from all over the world, from New York, from Miami, from Chicago, LA, from Canada, from UK or no, you know.
Yes.
Underground Legend. Body One was better this year. I got the project for the.
I'm gonna do two things for you. Not only am I gonna do that, but what I'm gonna do is get a track right, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hop on one of your joints. Now, as soon as people hear you on one of my records, see, the way that my records drop, I get a lot of hits and a lot of views on my records. And you're about to see me on the Reverb scale because the way that my campaign is set up, I'm about to become number one on Earth.
I already heard what you tell yesterday on the radio, you know.
Uh-huh.
Your state of mind, I already love it. You know, you're hustling, man. You got to do yourself thing. You got to promote yourself. Artists that had time to promote himself. You know, I really, really love what you talked yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And that's exactly the same thing that I'm doing for me is the same thing, the things that I'm going to put in place for you.
Mm-hmm.
And then the thing that's good about that is that once those things are in place, it's going to keep moving. And it's only going to escalate, and it's only going to build. And like I said, you do a track with me, automatically, within the first, maybe first 4 hours, you're going to have 35,000 hits off jump.
God bless you. God bless you, homie. So my big problem is about cash, you know, about money, something like that. That's why I talk to Robin if he can put music or iTunes for me.
Yes.
Here in Paris, I don't have ad people. When you don't have ad people, you can walk, you can be seen or something like that, man. I'm from the street. But I'm a hustler. I keep doing my thing, you know.
Yes.
The way I trust Robin. That's why I tell him to send my music. They're going to send me back something like money or something like that because I trust her, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I'd never sell my music, but people ask me all the time, NG, where we can buy your music? Must be here first, you know. So we got to do it huge, man. You know, work with me. I'm no kind of snitch, you know.
Yeah.
I show the love, those who show me the love back, you know.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. And I don't want to talk too much. I don't want to talk too much before. Let us start this show, you know. I got a lot of connection.
Mm-hmm.
I put a Robin with connection with Jamie.
Yes.
I want to put her on connection with DJ Franchise from New York.
Yes.
Sugar, a guy station radio, a great station radio. We're about to release a mixtape tonight, the worldwide mixtape, where we got artists from all over, around the world. If you turn my Facebook page, you can see the shit. We got artists from Canada, from UK, the worldwide.
And I'm giving Coach the link to SoundCloud so that he can see the variety of the same people that you're speaking about right now. And I'm also gonna give him the Facebook page too.
Okay. Before I talk too much, let Coach listen what I do, and we can back on. We can back on.
Yeah. I just put it in your Facebook, but you know what, Coach, I can play something right now. Let me just do that right now, and we can hear it right now on the call.
I saw the picture of Coach on my page. Facebook.
Yeah, I put it up there. Listen, Coach, are you still here, Coach?
Yeah, I'm still here.
Okay, that picture that you had with little homie in the barbershop. NG made me admin of his Facebook page, and so I was like, well, shoot, so I'll be posting up everything over there. So I took that picture and I put it up over there.
My homie Sweat. Yeah.
Okay, now do you want me to play Lost Generation again, or I want to play something else?
You can play Underground King whenever. My track, I trust all my track, you know me. All my track is the best for me. Whenever the track of NG play, you can play wherever you want, you know. Underground King. You can play Underground King.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm on your SoundCloud page, so I gotta get. I haven't been here in a while, so I gotta get from the Underground King. There we go.
NG.
bitch, you bless. Oh yeah. Yeah. This happened the first time I played this too. When I do you my shit, nigga call me NG. I'm an underground king, don't tell me nothing. When I do you my shit, I make more shit right now. Red business, nigga play my shit. Fuck up with these niggas, I'm ready to fuck. Everything what I do, head I give my best. We a G from the sea, I know they bless my back. Shout out to my man, F.O.K. Pura G. I pop red game, but I ain't famous. Young poison, go your knees and my dream. When I talk about rappers, everything is raining. Thanks, I rap trippy. And she black, I'm giddy. Check the way I want it. All I need to say, stay on my way like you heard. I play that. I keep rapping, knowing my father don't try me. Don't tell me nothing when I do it. Don't tell me nothing. I'm an underground king. Don't tell me nothing when I do it. I made more shit right now. My presence red game, some lose control. Excuse me when I show you that I'm the best. Shut the fuck up, you don't understand what I mean. We underground, one what I'm talking about. I don't wanna give a fuck, but I put him the blessed. Oh, badass bitch, come suck my dick. Push out, won't stop, people join me rap. Three and again, very stage black, I'm the first. Kiko Bros, most I just had a way on earth. Who's who, and go boy, oh my god, my bed. I will keep a police for the next step. I beg one more time on me step. The radio needs the most, gonna play this track. Don't stop, old friend, I respect my dog. Junior Ovio, let's see, there we happen in here. It's big connection with MC Dice, man. Don't tell me nothing when I don't tell me nothing.
I'm an underground king. Don't tell me nothing when I do it my shit. I make more shit
right now.
Keep on me, nigga. Don't tell you this. I prefer smoke weed and I love to fuck. Never mind about me the way I live my life. That's how motherfuckers are supposed to be. Spending time on the studio where I make my song. Hey, there's anything I'm a hustler, I'm ready